This is to all you guys out there that think, you know what, I don't have to do these services. I don't have to do brake fluid service on my car. It doesn't need it. I didn't do it 20 years ago. I'm not doing it now. Well, we're here to tell you, you know what, things have changed. So this is why. We're going to tell you why. It's the water underneath this oil. It's the whole problem here. Got a story for you. John's got some experience. We're both, look at us, we're both got some experience with older cars and modern cars. John, you got experience with water in the brake fluid like this?
Well, yeah, for sure. There has been instances where people have been driving along, say a 2-3 hour drive in the heat and everything, and they're driving along and they step on their brake and the brake pedal goes to the floor. They can't stop the vehicle. If they hit something or whatever, it's not good. But what'll happen is they'll come out of the vehicle, it'll cool down, and all of a sudden you have a brake pedal again. And they couldn't figure out why until they'd done some testing and figured out that it was the brake fluid that was boiling, especially after a long drive, and it does wear out.
So that's really the big thing that we're going to say here is what happens is the moisture gets in here. The stuff looks the same. We're going to show you how we test for it, test for moisture content. But what happens is when this is under pressure now, it runs out into the calipers and it's squeezing that brake material, the friction material on, and it gets hot. It's not unusual to see braking temperatures of 400, 500, 600 degrees. I don't know, I've been to the racetrack at night. You can watch anyone likes watching racing at night. You go out and you see the cars making the oval in the dark. You'll see that brake come on. It'll be glowing red right through the wheels. That's how hot it's getting. So when you get this high moisture content brake fluid down into that vicinity where there's that much heat, what happens is the moisture component begins to volatilize. It begins to generate steam and evaporate. So now you've got not air pockets, but gas pockets of liquid water or water vapor. And so the brakes can't hold. They can't grab like they're supposed to. So we're going to go through a little demonstration here of what it is, how we test. We're going to show everybody how we flush, which is very important. It's one of those things that it's not so much a mileage thing, but it's a time thing. Here's an example of what's going on here. This is the brake fluid product that we like. It's a BG product. We're using DOT 4 in this car here. This is just pure brake fluid right here. I'm just going to give everybody a little image here. What happens? You're going to add a splash of water, just a little cup of water here, adding a splash. You remember how when we looked at it with the oil and the vinegar, or the oil and vinegar, the oil and water and the other one, there was a separation here. You see what's happening here is this material here is dissolving the water. It's completely homogeneous solution here. So what happens is it sits there, it looks like brake fluid. We're not testing for it. It looks the same as it did just before I added that water in. But something happens. These cars behave differently these days. So these cars have somehow become more sensitive. They're a little bit more affected by moisture content in the brake fluid, more affected at least than they were with previous systems. Some of those systems were much bigger design, much more forgiving when it came to the water effect in the sort of the brake fluid. So let's get into it. Let's see what we're doing here. John's got a tester and let's just walk us through. John, show us what we're doing here.
So this is a little pen. It's got a gauge on it and it does a continuity test. So it'll measure the moisture in the brake fluid. So let's go. Right now it's green, it's not picking up anything. Let's put it in the...
Ooh, look at that.
And there you go. This one needs a brake fluid flush badly.
So what is that? Does it give you a percentage on that, John? Is it telling you
what? Yeah, that should be about 10%.
10% water.
10% water.
So the cutoff on these things, so what we call 3.7% is sort of the general mark, the cutoff point for good hydraulic or brake fluid. And wet brake fluid, that's what the technical term for it is, wet fluid, which means got to change it, change me now. So with 3.7 is the threshold, and this thing here, it's what is this, an 8-year-old car?
Yeah.
It's
2015.
Doing the math, I guess that comes out to almost 10 years, or 10 a little bit more, yeah. 10 years. Probably original brake fluid in this, and we see what's happening. It's crept all the way up into the danger zone. So anyways, what are we going to do?
We're going to flush the system.
We're going to flush it. We're going to show you how we do that. What we're using here is we're using a motor vac brake fluid flush machine. There's all kinds of brake flush fluid machines out there. The power supply for this comes right off the car battery. We clip on power supply positive, negative. The machine lights up. There's a pump in here. We're going to use that to drive. John's going to use it here to drive brake fluid into the master cylinder reservoir, down through,
out.
We're going to control, sort of in a bidirectional manner, we're going to control the ABS module. For a bleed,
okay.
And we're going to push all clean fluid down, dirty fluid out. It's going to come out at all four corners, and we're going to be good to go. You can do this at home if it's a do-it-yourself type thing. You can do it by, how would we do that? We try to get as much fluid out of that reservoir as we can.
Yeah, put new fluid in through
new
the whole
fluid
system.
In, and then you got to sit in the car and you got to start pumping. So if you're pumping and you want to get all that fluid out, down through the bleeders out, how long is that going to take you? That's going to be
an hour.
An hour? An hour of pumping on brakes. So you can do it if you got a big right leg, you know, and you're feeling pretty good about yourself. You want to pump brakes for an hour, you can probably do it manually. But this machine is set up. It does it brilliantly. It's automated. It pumps fluid in. And we're going to show everyone just how quickly and how effectively it works. And this guy is going to be driving this car for, you know, another 3-4 years without any brake problems whatsoever. So let's go. Let's see how we're doing.
So what we're going to do is use an adapter. Every vehicle has different types of adapters. And they fit right on here to seal the master cylinder. So that way you don't lose any, you won't have a spewing fluid over or anything. It'll go right into the master, push it through the ABS module, through the master cylinder, through the flexos, and through the calipers. So let me hook up the machine here. This is the machine, which is this. This is where the new fluid's going to come out of. Now I'll turn the machine on, and you can regulate the pressure that you want. I don't like to go more than 20 psi. 15 is good, 10, it's just pushing the old fluid out and in through the calipers. So now we're going to raise the vehicle, and we're going to leave the brakes.
So here we go, here's the caliper right here. This is where we're going to get to service point. We're going to watch John do his magic. And you can see the bleeder screw. We're going to go in. He's going to show everyone how he's doing that. But this is the low point of the car. And if you remember that one little flask that I had with the water on the bottom, oil floating on top, if the brake fluid wasn't hygroscopic and it allowed it to separate like that, this is where the water would go, the lowest point of the car. So you get to that minus 20, minus 30, right? You get freezing here. So it simply can't work like that. If you get a frozen block of ice down here in your caliper, you're not going to be able to put any hydraulic pressure on to get these brakes to come on. So that's the essence of the problem. The fluid itself must dissolve water. But when you get too much water, now you're onto this other problem. So we're gonna get down here, we're gonna show you how to flush it out, and here comes John.
So the first thing I'm gonna do is make sure that the bleeder screw opens. This is where the fluid's gonna come out of. Okay, and it's open. So now I'm gonna turn the machine on, put some pressure on it, and you're gonna see fluid coming out of here, and it should become a steady drip, and it'll clear out the line through the ABS, the caliper, and you're going to have fresh fluid. And we're going to do that to all four wheels, and that way we have fluid in all four wheels, all brand new fluid in the master cylinder, ABS unit, calipers, and then we should be good. So let me turn the machine on and I'll show you what happens. There it is. Now the pressure's going back and forth. It's pushing new fluid in through this hose. And there's fluid coming out of there. Now, I like to use at least one or two liters of fluid, brake fluid, and that way we know we got all new fluid in the system. It'll clear out the master cylinder, the ABS unit, again, like I say, the calipers, flex hoses, everything. This will all be new fluid inside here, and we don't have to worry about moisture or that for, you know,
a
year or two.
So, John, do you ever have a problem with air up in here? Like, this, the way that you're doing this, obviously, air is a problem.
Air can be a problem, yes, but...
But this machine solves that problem.
It solves that problem because as it's pushing the fluid through, it's putting new fluid in, so you can't have air in that system.
So to any of the folks that are doing it at home, yes, you can do it at home, but you got to be very, very careful. You're not... So if you want to sort of get ahead of it and sort of evacuate all the fluid from the reservoir, you get a problem with air going
there.
If
you get air
very
in there,
careful.
Then you so get another problem, yes.
Yeah, so if you're going to pump out, you suggest they leave a little bit at the bottom.
Yes.
Add there and
just
then
keep adding. Don't let it go empty.
But this system here, ordinarily we'd have like return lines had up here.
Yep.
So for the purpose of a video, we just thought having it clearly drained out, we can see the difference of coloration already. Right?
Yeah. Yeah. It's already becoming clear. So this side of the brake system for this caliper, for this line, for the ABS unit, and for this wheel, it's coming out nice and clean. So we're going to go ahead and do the other side. We're going to do the fronts. We'll have new fluid. We'll clean all this up, and we should have a happy customer.
Customer would be stopping on a dime.
Stopping on a dime and getting change back.
And the big thing, too, is, you know, we keep sort of, in the aftermarket repair business, what we're talking about is, you know, how do you keep your car on the road longer? That is the number one way to save money when it comes to auto repair. It's like, we all go and we buy these cars, and we all have to deal with the depreciation of the cars. And the best way to offset all these costs that come along, like fuel, oil, mechanical services, is to keep that car on the road for longer periods of time, which this will do, and it will reduce the repairs that have to be done over time. And you get the added value of knowing that you're going to stop whenever you need to stop.
Yeah. And as you mentioned before, if you overheat the caliper and the caliper fails for whatever reason, this being an electronic parking brake caliper is about $1,500.
So there you go.
If you want to, and $1,500 each.
You know, you say you're really, most likely you're saving thousands of dollars
you
by
are.
Doing a $100 sort of service on the car.
So now we can close this up because we're happy with it. Important thing is wear gloves because that'll take the moisture out of your skin. So wear rubber gloves and should be happy. So we're going to clean this up. We're going to do the rest of it and this car's back on the road. Okay, so here we have an older vehicle, 1998. It's got a huge caliper, two pistons. So moisture wasn't as important on these ones as it is on the newer vehicles. They're a lot smaller, work harder, heat up faster, and they can cause an issue. Not to say that these won't, but the newer cars are more prone to breaking down because of brake fluid.
Well, for all you guys that said, why do I have to do my brake fluid flush? This is it. Here's it in a nutshell. You look at the size of this caliper. It's basically the size of my hand. Think back to that Monte Carlo that I had back when I was a teenager. It was a brake caliper like this, and the disc on it was out like this. It was way more forgiving when it came to this sort of moisture, steam, vapor problem in the brake line. So you can see the size of it. You see what we're trying to do here. If you haven't had your brakes done in a while, you're going to wonder why your pedal's going soft. It's a huge, huge safety concern. You want to get it done a couple times over the life of your car. You won't have to worry about it. Get in to see your neighborhood mechanic. Get in to see your independent repair shop guy. And he'll tell you, yes, this is something you have to do. Thanks again for watching our videos. You know what? Leave a comment. We love to hear what everyone has to say. We love some of the discussion that happens here. Nothing like the little community that forms about how you're doing this at home, when you had it done, what happens when you didn't have it done, all that kind of great stuff. Leave a comment. Appreciate you watching. Steve at the Auto Station.